Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. We're going to discuss an idea of isomerism, specifically constitutional or structural isomers. So isomers arise when you have two molecules that have the same molecular formula and yet different connectivity, different connections between the atoms. So we have two molecules listed on the left. They have molecular formulas of C3H8O, and note that the atoms are it's first carbon, then hydrogen, then the alphabetical listing of the other elements. There's just one in this case. And the top formula is for propanol, and the bottom one is for isopropanol. So molecular formula doesn't show you connectivity, but condensed molecular structures and Lewis structures will give you connectivity information. So I'm going to, without knowing the structure, you can't draw these structures. So let me write out the condensed molecular structure for propanol. It looks like this. There are three carbons in a chain, and then an OH, or alcohol, hanging off the end. Another way people might write this is they might say it's a CH3 on the end, and then two of these CH2s. So they just write CH2, put that in parentheses, and say you're going to have two of those together, and then an OH. Either of those are acceptable condensed molecular structures. For isopropanol, it's a little bit different. We're actually going to have two CH3 groups connected to a CH and then an OH. So let's draw these Lewis dot structures. For this, the top structure for propanol, we have a carbon, and it's attached to three hydrogens. There's our CH3 on the left. Continuing towards the right, we have a CH2. So that carbon is attached to another carbon that has two hydrogens. And then we have yet another carbon that's attached to two hydrogens. And then we have the oxygen, which is attached to a hydrogen. Now, this oxygen does not, as shown, doesn't have a full octet, and these oxygens typically have two lone pairs, and that completes the structure. Now, let's go down to isopropanol. There are a couple ways we could tackle this, but I like to emphasize the fact that these are written from left to right, and we should read them from the left to the right. So we have a CH3, and we're going to have actually two CH3s, and they're both coming off of one carbon. So we've shown one of our CH3s. Let's put a letter A and circle it next to there. And there's B, and this is going to be A and B, and they're both attached to carbon C. Carbon C has a hydrogen on it, and then the last bond of carbon is to the oxygen, which has an H. And again, we have this problem with oxygen needs a full octet, so we give it two lone pairs to complete its octet. So these are two structures that have the exact same molecular formula, C3H8O, and yet they have different structures. And so as we get to more complex ways to communicate structure and composition, we start to see that the connectivity of these are different. These are called constitutional or structural isomers.